Howdy folks, I know it's been a while since I've had any videos on this 10 horse Alice Chalmers antique motor. And if you remember the last video, the shaft and bushings were worn and the rotor was rubbing inside here. So I took the shaft to the machine shop. Well, today I got it back. And the destroyed keyway is like new. The scored and undersized journal is like new. And the bushing's been reboard and had new oil grooves put in it. Also, the bent oil ring is fixed up. And then the other bushing, it wasn't too badly worn, just a little bit. So I didn't have anything done to that one, and it's still fine like it is. So this was built up and then machined down and polished. I don't know the exact amount that was taken off or added to it. But bushing fits on there real nice. So I'm going to have to do the washing and cleaning of these end bells, get them ready to accept the new parts, and then maybe start going back together with it. Now, like I said, it took a long time to get the shaft back from the machinist. And when I left it with them, I told them that this motor is not part of anyone's business. Nobody's losing money but this is down, so it wasn't a hurry. And they've been very, very busy the last 3 years or so since our economy's been doing so well. A lot of local industry is, you know, going strong, and they're doing a lot of maintenance work, and so the machinist has been busy. And I told them that I wasn't in a hurry, so finally got a slow spell right around the winter holidays, and I went and picked it up. This is like 2 days before Christmas, so it was a Christmas gift, I guess you could say. Well, you know, the subject matter is pretty large when you have to put the tripod on the workbench just to get the camera up high enough. So did a little parts cleaning. Got it where it's not gonna have any grit or dirt gonna come out and contaminate the bushings, new bearings. And there's a little bit of that white paint they had in there, but I'm not too worried about that. So the way this oiling system works, I've explained before, is this ring sits in here, and as the shaft turns, the ring turns, and this bottom part is in oil, so it lifts the oil up. And you can see the grooves inside there. So the oil falls in this slot, and it goes in this groove, and then oils the bushing and the shaft. So this part has to go inside first. And it's engineered so that you can put this in and it'll sit over the bore. Then once this is finally installed, this set screw goes in that little dimple to hold it in place. So if I set this down in there, like so, you have to bear with me because the camera may move around since the tripod is on the bench and I'm gonna end up bumping things. So the oil ring's in its place. Oop. You can look down in there. See the ring in place in there. So now what I have to do is get the set screw in that little hole. I'm not sure how enjoyable this video is going to be for people to watch, because again, I don't know what you're going to be able to see because the camera's up too high for me to be looking at the viewfinder while I work like I usually do. So I'm probably off screen right now. So that screw fell in. Definitely a large motor. Looking for that dimple right there. Feels like it's almost started, but not quite. I did run a brass bristle tube brush through there to try and make sure that none of those threads were clogged up with debris. Wondering if I should have run an actual tap through there, but maybe it's starting. Yeah. So it started in there now. Get it down a little further, then I'll have to get a screwdriver. All right, go get the screwdriver and finish tightening it. One weakness to this design that I see, the oil ring is not in the bushing groove until I drop it down in there. So it's possible for that to get kicked up and not be in the groove where it's going to oil the shaft. Now, I don't know if there could be some parts missing out of this that weren't there when I got the motor. I just don't know. But that's something that'll definitely have to be checked anytime this is run, especially if the motor's been moved and there's a chance that it got bounced. And you know, these bushings were damaged severely, so I wonder if that could have been the cause. Somehow that got kicked out of there like that, and someone didn't realize it until it was too late. So that's the rear housing. Now I'll repeat the same with the front one. Well, I took it back apart. I was not satisfied with the possibility of that ring jumping out of there, so I made a modification. You can see this groove has been cut in there. All right, this is the other bushing for the other end. I went ahead and put the slot in it. So the problem that I'm trying to keep from happening is where this jumps out and sits up there instead of on the shaft. So with this assembled in the motor, this pin will slide in like that. Then when this retaining bolt is put in to hold the bearing in place, it traps that. And then with this pin in there, that can't jump out. So that's the theory anyway. And this is soft copper wire, so it's not real strong. But then again, there's not really anything that's going to make force up on this. So it would just be an accidental bounce that it's going to restrain it from happening. I'm going to try to video the full assembly of this, this end bell. Now, I tried once, and I had to hone that. And also had to polish down the outside of the bushing, because something was tight. So the first thing that happens is the oil ring goes in here. And it sits on top of the part of the casting where the bearing goes in. So the bearing can slide through there without catching on it. And then the next thing, bearing itself is going to go in. Seats down like so. And now I'm going to have to pick it up and work from the front to put my modification in there. I'm not sure how useful this part of the video is going to be, but I'm going to try. So this pin has to go in the oil ring down in its slot where it's got to go to work. I had it in there before, I know it fits. It's just a matter of getting the right angle. Alright, now it's starting in. You see it's right there in the bolt hole.
Man, bushing went in all the way. Now I just got to slide that that pin forward. Which is, shouldn't be that hard. Trying to video something makes it take longer and harder. So I hope everyone appreciates that and understands that it makes the job more difficult. But I do it anyway.
And now I'm trying to rotate the bushing where the lock bolt hole lines up.
Forgive me if I'm all kinds of off screen right now. It's almost there.
That's it, the wire is in place. Now to put this part in. Hopefully it goes in smoothly. Yeah, how about that? Okay, I think that is retained. Okay, I set the rotor in there after I got it all cleaned up and painted, the shaft put in, and I'm going to attempt to install the rear housing. In order for this oil ring to work, I'm going to have to start out with the housing upside down, and then once it has gone past the shaft with the oil ring, I can turn it over. So the shaft's past the oil ring, now I'll rotate it around to the right position. It should slide right on. I'm just going to start the bolts. I'm not going to try to pull it down, because without the front housing on there, it's, you know, there's an angle involved. I'm just going to put these bolts in there loosely, kind of keep everything in place. After the front housing's on, then the rest of the bolts can be tightened down all the way. All right, flip it around and check the other end out. All right, gonna try to install the front cover. Again, I'm coming in upside down with it, so the oil ring will be retracted. It's about that far on, then I can spin it around. Just like so. So one thing about this motor, and a lot of these motors, is It's magnetically centered, which means there's no thrust bearing in it. Now, some of them have some fiber washers just to act as a bump stop. But normally when the motor's running, the magnetic field holds the rotor in the center where it doesn't have to worry about thrust bearings. Now, one of the thrust faces of the bushings was severely worn. And I think problem was the last people that worked on it pressed the shaft in the rotor to the wrong depth. So I pressed it in and I tried to line up the step in it where it was equal on both sides. So hopefully that's going to be good. If not, I may have to take it back apart and make some measurements and adjustments. But time will tell. All right, time to put a little oil in there. I've just got some SAE 50 oil. I know that's a real heavy grade, but that's what I want because this is a slow RPM motor and it'll help cushion the bearings really nicely. I'm going to put that in until it shows up in this little cap down here, which I realize is off screen right now, but I can't do anything about it at the moment. It looks like it's coming up in there. So now, should be okay to turn it. I did notice while I was assembling it, it sounds like there's a piece of tape or something in there rubbing, which I don't particularly like. Get a little bit of oil worked in there. Did you hear that rub it's got? So I think at this point, it's ready for a test run. Get some power hooked up to it. All right, I'm gonna do probably two startups for the video, and that'll conclude it today. There is still a rub, and it's not a metal on metal rub. It's just some probably a piece of insulation or something. And what I'll need to do is take the rotor back out and inspect carefully and try to polish it down. So the first start is going to be on 110 volt with the capacitor bank. So here we go. I bet you can see the oil circulating in there with that ring. All right, now I'm going to stop it. That braking effect was from kicking the capacitor back in. All right, this start's gonna be on the phase converter, 240 volt three phase. And the converter is my really sick one that I've been talking about, how sad it is with the bad bearings. So you're gonna have to hear that noise. But I'm gonna start the converter and then start the motor. The magnetic centering is working. If you look at how far out the shaft sticks, if I shake the motor, it'll go in and out both ways without bumping. That tells me it's floating right in the middle and not riding on any of the bushings. That's just what it should do. one more start. This time I put the converter outside, so you won't have to hear it as loud. So here we go. Obviously, there's still work yet to do, but I'm happy I've got all the parts back here, and bearings are good, and it's running, so I'm that much further ahead. I just hate to have to take it apart again, because every time you take that heavy rotor out, there's a chance that it could hit the winding, and I always have to take my time doing that, but it is what it is. So, thanks for watching, and catch you later.